Okay, welcome back. So, let's go with it. Let's see what we can do. I would like more naval supply, obviously. But money right now, big problem for me. I mean, I still have fairly low administrative spending, which is not what you want. Okay, I've got as many soldiers as I'm going to get from here. So let's take a look at our focuses, where we might want to put them. Let's go ahead and actually train our people to be soldiers. Rather than, you know, the colonials. Now, let's see. You know, I don't want to just be influencing Colombia, I think, even though that's a good one to get because of the canal. Let's not lose prestige. Let's go ahead and be influencing Spain. Okay, there. Got myself another tech. Now, whatever I get here, ideally finish researching pretty much right at the end of the year. How long would that take? So I want something, what would something on this level take? That might be close enough. I'm okay with wasting a, Yeah, let's go ahead and go with the iron. That'll take a bit longer. That's okay. 5 January, that's a pretty good way to place a stop. Anyway, as I was saying, January 5th of 69 is not a bad place to cut off, you know, start banking research points for 1870 when the, when machine guns becomes available. There we go. Ooh, now I can get lots of troops in Africa. Well, what do I need? I've kind of been doing this haphazardly, right from the start, which you don't want to do. So let's see this army. Merge them together, split you apart, because that's clearly not a well-built stack. Merge you together. Delete the bad troops. Oh no. Okay, there we go. So, some slight problem with the interface there. This side of the button didn't work so well. But hey, so anyway, get rid of, send one of the infantry to a different army. And that makes that into a good one. Oh, and, by the way, create protectorate. Create protectorate. There we go. Some new colonies, which I will not be turning into actual colonies yet. Protectorates are just fine for the moment. So let's let these split up and see what they each need. You need 2 more artillery and an engineer, and 2 more infantry. So let's go to build army. Oh, and also a cav, of course. So I'm getting you that. And that. And that, and that. And that'll be a good army. This army, I think I might want to relocate, though. Commerce raiders. Have the transports kind of be their own thing, so they can zip around quickly. I'm not at war or anything. So you go way over here, just in case you're needed. Expand your naval base. You know, I really want to make sure I have all the ships I can and have plenty of supply limit for them. Right, so Sokoto. I would really like to annex Sokoto before the scramble starts, but I have the problem that my infamy, I got caught right away on Ethiopia. And that's very unfortunate. I mean, I'll still think about it, but you know, when you get caught right away on something like that, it kind of hurts. But we'll see what I can do about it. Maybe I'll still, maybe I'll still just try to risk it. Hope I don't go over my infamy limit. And if I do, let's see, do I have anything I could just really, like Zanzibar or something? You know, not a huge loss. Moralism. Yeah, let's see if we can slightly lower the militancy in Kyushu. Unemployment's down. That's good news. Got better coal production. But I would really like to annex Sokoto. That would really put me in a good position. Oh, hey, I have another focus point available. Awesome. I'm just going to do soldiers. Really be ready to get my military up and running. Naval base expansion. So I might actually be in a better position than I thought in terms of naval bases. Not perfect, but bearable. Alrighty. Yeah, merge up. Discredited in Spain. Maybe I should not be influencing them while I'm discredited, but hey. It's actually not a huge problem to do that right now. When these ironclads finish, I'll be over my supply limit for navies, but I'm going to go ahead and build more because I can start disbanding commerce raiders. Now, here's the question. How much am I willing to risk for Sokoto? So that would help me if that would really help me get West Africa here. But if I'm going to do it, I have to do it very soon. So this is probably going to be, this is almost certainly going to be the last episode before I go on break of Victoria 2. So I'm going to open it up to you, audience. Should I risk going over the infamy limit to try to annex Sokoto? Or should I play it safe and maybe just go for, say, you know, a concession off of them, like Benin maybe, and save the rest for later, but at least it opens up this corridor? Well, let me know what you think. I mean, I already have this base here, or down here. So I'll probably be able to colonize up here anyway, you know, but I could get a lot, I'd have a chance of getting Volta, for example, if I can finish annexing Sokoto fast enough. I don't know, it might already be too late, but I ramble. let me know what you think at the end of the episode. I know, any time I waste here certainly makes it less and less appealing. But hey. Okay, so yeah. That was actually really good timing for me in terms of research finishing. Because now it's time for me to stockpile and get machine guns before everybody else. I think I need another hussar out here. What do I need in the homeland? Basically everything. I have very little army up here. So, I'm gonna go ahead and just build some artillery. Good stuff, good stuff. And I think things coming along quite nicely. Ooh, serious unemployment in Kyushu though. Let's go ahead and open this steel factory and even subsidize it. Even though I'm in a situation where I really need money. Let's open the liquor factory too. It probably doesn't need any subsidy because it's a liquor factory. I mean, those things are crazy profitable. Naval base. Naval base. Okay, no more naval bases at the moment because I don't have money. But you know, I'm thinking I will, in fact, take the risk on Sokoto. So, I know I asked for your opinions, but if you say I shouldn't risk it, I'm going to disregard it. Because here's the thing. The max I can get is 10. I could get a lot less. And really, I only need to get away with another... I need to get like 30% of the way through the justification. And if I do get caught, I can release Zanzibar. So, going for it. And in the next episode, whether I get caught or not, I'll be ready to go to war. And, you know, hopefully... Well... We'll see. But we'll see how it turns out. Hopefully I don't need to release Zanzibar. If I do, not a huge problem. Anyway, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it, and have a good day. Okay.